Welcome to the National Shrine of Our Lady here at Walsingham. Hundreds of thousands of pilgrims come each year to visit this most ancient shrine of the Mother of God. And in England, it is one of the most important Marian shrines because of the events of 1061. To understand what happened in Walsingham in 1061, all those years ago, it's important to understand a particular description of England. It's a unique description of England, and that is that England is Mary's dowry. That means that England was given to our Blessed Lady, and there is a long and even more ancient tradition that goes back about the devotion to the Mother of God of the people of this country. Because of that great devotion, one of the fruits was as there was a woman here in Walsingham called Richeldis, and she was the Lady of the Manor. And Richeldis had a great devotion to our Blessed Lady, and she wanted to do something to honour the Mother of God. And she prayed and prayed. And we hear that what happened was that Our Lady made herself known to Richeldis and asked her to build a replica of the Holy House of Nazareth.
Our Lady wanted a holy house, a replica of the Holy House in Nazareth, to be built here at Walsingham so that people coming here can experience that same joy that she had when she accepted her call to be the Mother of God.
Now, the Holy House of Nazareth was the place where Our Lady lived with St. Joachim and St. Anne. And in that house, the Annunciation took place. And so Our Lady took Richeldis, as it says, in spirit to Nazareth to be able to see exactly what the Holy House looked like. And the message was quite simple, that Our Lady wanted her to build a house, a holy house, so that we could share in Our Lady's joy at the Annunciation.
At the Annunciation, Our Lady was able to give a total and complete yes to God's love for her, to his call for her. She was invited to be the Mother of God, and she was able to say this complete yes.
Our Lady's great joy was that her son was also her saviour. And she wanted us, and she wants us today, and she wants you today to be able to share in that joy. So Walsingham is a Marian shrine of the Incarnation. It's the place where Our Blessed Lady asked Richeldis to share her joy and to build something here in Walsingham where we could come and share her joy. And we know the long history of the shrine. We know that during the reign of King Henry VIII, in 1538, the shrine was destroyed and the statue of Our Lady of Walsingham was taken to Chelsea and was burned along with other medieval statues of Our Lady. But the Mother of God is the mother of a God who is always with us, who never leaves us. And so a woman called Charlotte Boyd came and bought the only remaining building, which is called the Slipper Chapel. And the Slipper Chapel is the only building that wasn't destroyed. It's 1 mile outside of the village. And it's the place where pilgrims, when they walked on pilgrimage to Walsingham, when they got to the Slipper Chapel, they went to confession. And then, as an act of penance for the last mile, they walked down the so-called Holy Mile to the great priory of Our Lady of Walsingham. And they walked barefoot. And that is still a very great tradition today, that many pilgrims walk that holy mile. Another great person came along as well to Walsingham, and that was Father Hope Patton, who was the Anglican vicar. And he had a great devotion to Our Lady of Walsingham, and he established the shrine, the Anglican shrine of Our Lady of Walsingham, which is in the village as well, which has a replica of the Holy House. So there is much to see when you come to Walsingham. But at the heart of our history is a story, a simple message. Come and share in the joy of Mary in the annunciation of her son, that he became flesh and lived among us. Come and share in that joy when you come to Walsingham, England's Nazareth.
Today, as in the past, pilgrims come to Walsingham for many reasons. But the heart of a pilgrimage is to give thanks and to seek the will of God in our lives. The story of Walsingham centres around three women who in their lives sought to do the will of God. Our Blessed Lady's fiat, her yes, meant that the Word became flesh and lived among us. Rosheldis, by her desire to honour the Mother of God, built the Holy House, which established Walsingham as a centre of worship and evangelisation. Charlotte Boyd, by her great charity, brought about the restoration of the Slipper Chapel so that once again it could be used as a place of Catholic worship, as in days gone by. As you prepare for your pilgrimage, contemplate the great mystery of the Incarnation, which has drawn you to Walsingham. Your pilgrimage is an invitation to participate in the new evangelization, to grow in the knowledge of your faith, to live your faith, and to share your faith. So let's meet some of the people who will help you to enter into a deeper experience here at the Shrine in Walsingham. I'd like to introduce to you Zig Vakovits. He is the Director of Evangelization at the Catholic National Shrine of Our Lady. So Zig, what does the shrine have to offer a pilgrim?
James, so a pilgrim to Walsingham today will see a number of changes, a number of enhancements to the domain. So alongside the old, which many of you will recognise, the crosses from 1948, which line this central area of the shrine site. We've also now introduced the Stations of the Cross, a very beautiful representation of the way of the cross through the eyes of Jesus, through the eyes of Our Lady. And at each station, there's an invitation and a prayer to encourage the pilgrim on their journey. Walsingham is a unique place in every Catholic's faith journey in England. It's the place where, since 1061, pilgrims have been coming.
When I started working at the Shrine, I spent time talking to the pilgrims about what's special in Walsingham, you know, why do they come to Walsingham? And I was really struck by how many of them said that they all have different places that they're drawn to, that they can have silence, time to spend praying. And I think for me, then I went on a journey to find out what was special and to fall in love with Walsingham, and it takes time. I think it takes time and silence to really discover what's on offer here.
So how do you prepare to come on retreat? How do you prepare to come on pilgrimage? Essentially, what's in your heart at the moment? Who do you want to pray for? What are your worries? What are your concerns? What do you hope for? What great burden have you carried? Because these are the intentions that we bring when we come to Walsingham. We come as an act of faith, not just to see a very nice part of the countryside. So be clear before you come, what is your intention? What is it that's challenging you at this moment in your life? And come to seek to do the will of God. To seek God's will in a place where Our Lady came and asked us to rejoice with her is to seek to do what she did, to do God's will. Santa Maria.
The Holy House is a wonderful image of the soul or of the heart of each person, which needs to become poor and emptied of self so that God's love can fill it. And as God's love fills our hearts, we're able to listen better to His word and to respond to His word, to build our life on rock, and to be able to respond with the same generosity or similar generosity to Our Lady to that call in our life.
So when you come to Walsingham, that's the heart of what you must seek to do the will of God, and to receive the prayers and the encouragement of your fellow pilgrims, but to follow the example of our Blessed Mother, who said, do whatever He tells you. So what is here? Well, the Catholic shrine of Our Lady is here at the site of the Slipper Chapel, and that's where you will be coming on pilgrimage. But the remains of the ancient shrine are in the village, and all that's left of the church is the arch, known as the Lonely Arch. But in the ground you will see a cross, a very simple cross, which is the site of the original Holy House. You may be coming on your own or just with a small group. You may be coming on the coach. You may be watching this indeed on the way down to Walsingham at this moment. Whatever way you come, you are very welcome. And we have a very simple program here at Walsingham.
We're now in the grounds of the shrine. And the interesting question is, what can pilgrims do if they visit here? Our services start at 8:15 in the morning up in the village. And that's Angelus and morning prayer. For those staying in the hostels, 8:30 is breakfast. And then there's a procession that leaves from the village, goes down the Holy Mile, and arrives here in the shrine grounds. And that's at 10 o'clock. And at 11 o'clock, there's confession here in the Chapel of Reconciliation. At 12 o'clock, the Pilgrim Mass starts. After that, pilgrims sometimes stay down here and have their lunch in the tea rooms, or they go back up into the village, where there is an opportunity for lunch back in the hostels or around the village. At 2:30, the program starts again down here with rosary in the Slipper Chapel, followed by 3 o'clock adoration in the Chapel of Reconciliation. There's then time to explore, read about the Dowry Exhibition, which is the history of Our Lady's shrines in England. You could visit the reliquary, where we have the relics of the martyrs of England and other saints. You could also go back up into the village and go to the site of the original Holy House, or visit the Anglican shrine where they have the replica house. Evening prayer is at 6 o'clock in the Annunciation Church in the village. And at 8 p.m. there's a service that may involve a procession also at the Annunciation Church. If you're staying longer, then there's the opportunity to get to the beaches as well and explore the rest of North Norfolk.
Some people say, I'd love to stay overnight. Well, we have plenty of accommodation here. We have our accommodation at Elmham House. We have as well two shepherd's huts, which are where people can come and stay for a few days, actually based here at the shrine. Also, if you want to come on retreat, we have our new retreat centre, the Dowry Retreat House, which is in the village, which is located in two ancient pilgrim hostels.
This is a beautiful historic building, and parts of it date back to the 15th century because it was used as a pilgrim hostel when people came to Walsingham.
We offer spiritual accompaniment, retreats, hospitality, and we also give talks in schools and parishes so that many more people will come to know the beauty of the message of Walsingham.
We're situated just opposite the original Abbey grounds, and it's a beautiful location in the heart of the village. We enjoy welcoming guests here for prayer, for reflection, for their personal retreats, and also for conferences and retreats that the shrine runs throughout the year. So there's a couple of events you can look out for. 1061, which is a set of retreats, particularly for young adults, to really help them to grow in their Christian life.
One of the great initiatives that we've been running over the last year is the 1061 Formation Program, which is run here in Walsingham. Dowry House is beautiful. Mm. Great venue for a retreat.
Yeah, it's stunning.
Yeah.
Really special. Mm-hmm.
So the 1061 Formation Program is an opportunity for young people to go deeper in their faith into some key areas. So there's three of them, and they are prayer, scripture, and radical generosity. And these three together will really help us to live life to the full and respond to those calls to holiness and mission. It's been an extraordinary experience. Have you been on any of them?
Yeah, I've done two or three of them actually. A very special one for me really stood out was the radical generosity. How we can really give. I think our culture is very orientated towards self, and so being able to understand how we can grow in holiness by giving of ourselves in a way that is of Christ is very countercultural. So the experience of the 1061 retreat that I went on and the formation of that was amazing, really amazing. Yeah. Have you been?
Yeah, I went on the prayer weekend, and I was amazed. It was a silent weekend, which I didn't know about, but it was actually really, really incredible experience of just going so much deeper in my own prayer, in learning great tools of prayer, and just having an amazing speaker who's delivering great content, but also available for questions. These weekends are just great experiences for us to use in going deeper in our faith.
We also run retreats on the spirituality of Walsingham and how we can all live God's calling in our lives.
Now that we have been justified by faith, let us be at peace with God through Jesus Christ our Lord.
I think that one of the things that our guests really appreciate here is the silence, the beauty all around us, and also that they can join the sisters for the times of prayer throughout the day, so everything we do is just saturated in prayer.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death. Amen.
We also have a beautiful chapel where people can come and have Eucharistic adoration at any time they like, and we think that's a real gift for the whole village here, that we can come and have that time with our Lord. You'd be very welcome to come and stay here at Dowry House Retreat, either for your own individual quiet retreat, with your parish or prayer group, for one of our many retreats that the Shrine run throughout the year, or perhaps on an individually guided retreat, helping you to really get into scripture and see what the Lord is asking of you. Whatever type of retreat you come for, we're sure that this will be a place where you can really deepen in your prayer life, in your Christian living, and in the rich spirituality of Walsingham.
On arriving in Walsingham and moving up here from London, the question for me was what is special about Walsingham? I've been to other Marian shrines, other places of pilgrimage, and I think it takes time to let Walsingham reach you. And if you can allow that time of silence and just wander around the village and just allow Our Lady to take you on a tour, she will show you where to have those intimate moments with the Lord, as she did.
The Peter Sibley collection was given to the National Shrine of Our Lady in 2017, and they are now on display in a museum on the High Street. The collection is the work of a man, as I say, Peter Sibley, who was unable to work after the age of about 40, but spent the next 20 years of his life buying anything that had any connection with Our Lady. He bought medieval manuscripts, he bought pilgrim badges, statues of every type, and we have about 100 on display in the museum itself. There are two rooms in the museum. The one you can see now is probably the finer parts of the museum, the better statues, and I can see here 13th century illuminated manuscripts on the wall and Byzantine crosses. There are also pilgrim badges on display here, and we are very fortunate that there is a 99% perfect Walsingham pilgrim badge, which is better than any held in Norfolk at least, and possibly in the country. This is a remarkable collection, and it covers most aspects of medieval artifacts. And we are very fortunate that the collection has come to Walsingham and will be able to be viewed by our many thousands of pilgrims.
What would you say is the significance of the National Shrine?
Well, the National Shrine is, in a way, the heart of the faith in England. It's the place Our Lady asked Rochelle this to build a holy house as a testimony to that first moment of faith in the life of the new church, the New Testament. So in that way, this shrine is very unique. It's the place where the story of our salvation starts. It's a place where Walsingham is really put into the centre of that personal decision, that personal encounter with Christ and the decision to follow the Lord's will.
What is the best way for a pilgrim to plan their visit and to prepare themselves spiritually?
Well, the first thing to do is to visit our website, walsingham.org.uk, just to see what's on around the dates which you want to be travelling to the shrine. And the other thing to do is to get a copy of the Pilgrim Handbook.
One of the things you'll notice this year, if you've been a regular to Walsingham, is that we now have a new Pilgrim Handbook. And the object of the handbook is to help you during your time here, but also to be a very good prayer book. In the Pilgrim Handbook, you will see a new devotion called the Angelus Promise. Now, the Angelus Promise has been developed here to give us a framework to see how we can respond to Our Lady's call to share the joy in her Son. The Angelus, that wonderful simple prayer, is the heart of the message of Walsingham. And the three prayers of the Angelus really explain what happened at the Annunciation. And we have developed this prayer, this Angelus Promise, as a unique part of what you do when you come to Walsingham. It is a prayer that you can use. You can use it here, and we suggest that you make this promise in the Slipper Chapel, or you can make this promise down in the village at the site of the old house, the Holy House. And this promise is part of our spiritual preparation for a wonderful event that's going to happen on the Feast of the Annunciation 2020. And that is the rededication of England as the Dowry of Mary. These 2 years of preparation that we have will be there to help us for this wonderful event, where the gift in 2020 will not be the gift of the country of England, it will be the gift of the faith of the people of England. And the Dowry Promise, which we call the Angelus Promise, will be there to help you to make your unique gift to the Mother of God on the Feast of the Annunciation 2020. So I've spoken briefly about how to prepare for your pilgrimage and having the intention, spoken about what to do when you're here and the resources that we have to help you make your pilgrimage. But people come on pilgrimage and they have a wonderful time, but then they think, well, I've got to go home now. So what do you do when you go home? What impact does your pilgrimage have on your life? And there are three areas I just want to draw to your attention. Three which you know, the very heart of being a follower of Jesus Christ. The first, quite simply, is dedicate yourself to pray every single day. And if you haven't been praying, then start praying. And if you have been praying, spend as much time as you can in that generous building of your relationship with Jesus Christ. Because remember, prayer doesn't change God. Prayer changes me. That's why it's so powerful. Secondly, Jesus is described as the way, the truth, and the life. He gives that truth to us through the Word of God, through the teaching of the church, and through the wisdom of the saints. And like St. Paul says to us, make sure you have a reason for the hope that you have in Jesus Christ. And the third thing is so important. It's radical generosity, which is just another way for loving others as Jesus loved them. Don't give others what you can spare. Give what you can't spare. Be generous, be radically generous, because that is exactly what Jesus was. He gave and he didn't count the cost.
Even the Carmelite mystics and many saints talk about the need for us to be emptied of self so that Jesus can relive his paschal mystery in us. And it is a tough journey, but it is a most beautiful journey because it brings us to that true joy that Our Lady wishes to offer us here at the shrine. And for us as Christians to grow in that maturity of Christ that St. Paul talks about, so that going back home, we can experience that joy in every circumstance, in every encounter that we have.
If we are people of prayer, if we take the truth to ourselves, and if we can say like Jesus, this is my body and I give it to you, we are living a Eucharistic life. And we live it not just when we come on pilgrimage, we live it every day of our life. And this is the message of Our Lady, because that's the joy of living the Eucharist, the heart of our faith.
So this is the most beautiful message that we can have. And our feeling as a community is that if people understood how important Walsingham was for this country and for beyond, then pilgrims coming here would be able to be touched by that message and return home to live the spirituality in their homes, in their parishes, in their schools, in their workplaces. So England needs saints, men and women totally open to this love of God and to responding with this yes to his love in their particular calls. And this is where the message of Walsingham and its spirituality is so important for our country. And our hope is that many will be challenged by this invitation of Our Lady to live life to the full and share that joy with others. Then we become effective evangelizers for our country and beyond.
Keep us in your prayers, and we pray for all of you and your intentions every day. And remember the simple message of Our Lady at Walsingham, the reason for her joy, that is that the Word became flesh and lived among us. This is the cause of our joy. This is our hope. And this is what we celebrate at this great shrine of the Mother of God, England's Nazareth, Walsingham.
We hope you enjoyed watching this programme. This video was produced by EWTN, Great Britain, in partnership with the Catholic National Shrine of Our Lady at Walsingham. If you would like to know more about the work we are doing and to see our growing range of programming, please visit our website, ewtn.co.uk, where you can register for updates and access new content. Thank you, and God bless. Thank you.